Hi, Scotland has made sanitary products free to all women who need them, thus becoming the first country in the world to do so, a historic moment for Scotland, who has taken such a historic step against period poverty, after final approval was given for a landmark legislation by the Scottish Parliament. The measures are intended to end period poverty or the circumstances, and in some cases, prohibition expenses that have left many without access to sanitary products when they need them. This will make tampons and sanitary products available at designated public places such as community centres, youth clubs and pharmacies. The Scottish Government has estimated around US$32 million per year for this noble cause. Scotland also made history when it gave free sanitary products to schools, colleges and universities 2 years back in 2018 through a government program. A survey was conducted and it was found that 1 in 4 respondents were not able to access sanitary products in Scotland. Wales and England has also started similar programs when they have also started giving free sanitary products in schools. In UK, sanitary products are charged 5% tampon tax, a levy that the officials has blamed the European Union. But as of now, as Britain is out of the European Union, it is understood that they are going to remove this tampon tax in the year 2021. A draft bill for free products provision bill was initially given approval in February this year. And the measure was finally given approval last week when lawmakers unanimously agreed to the bill. And the First Minister of Scotland, Nicola Sturgeon, called it an important policy for women and girls. Under the legislation, the government will set up a Scotland-wide initiative setting up local authorities to allow anyone who needs sanitary products free of charge. The legislation lays out that reasonable choice of different period products will be made available to them, and also it will be delivered personally to them. It is not just the cost of the product that is an issue. A variety of circumstances make menstruation a difficult experience for women and girls, which includes poverty, homelessness, abusive relationships, and health conditions. Labour member Monica Lennon, who introduced and championed the legislation, thanked her colleagues and those who supported for period poverty and passing the bill. And I quote, "A proud day for Scotland and a signal to the world that free universal access to period products can be achieved," she had tweeted. The Scottish Parliament has shown both forward and progressive thinking, and that it can be a progressive force when needed. It has put an end to period poverty and has brought hope to the world in these tough times. A clear message of what kind of Scotland it want to be, and that being able to access period products is fundamental to equality. Now the question is whether this can happen in India.
An essential, but for Scotland's poorest, an expensive one. That's why lawmakers voted unanimously to make sanitary products freely available in all public buildings, making Scotland the first nation in the world to legislate against period poverty.
There were no votes against, there were no abstentions. The motion is agreed, and the Period Products Free Provision Scotland Bill is passed.
It was a move lauded by First Minister Nicola Sturgeon.
Proud to vote for this groundbreaking legislation, making Scotland the first country in the world to provide free period products for all who need them. An important policy for women and girls.
Research by Plan International reveals that during the first lockdown, almost a third of British girls struggled to either afford or access sanitary wear, forcing girls to use alternatives such as rags, newspapers and toilet paper. The new law means that public places in Scotland, including community centres, youth clubs and pharmacies, are expected to make sanitary towels and tampons available free of charge. The measure is set to cost almost 27 million euros per year and comes off the back of a previous measure in 2018 that saw free period products made available at schools, colleges and universities.
In India, it is still a societal restriction to talk about menstrual health. Women are barred to enter temples and also the kitchens during such times. Such practices need to change. Hundreds and thousands of girls are affected due to lack of menstrual hygiene, and it is part of their life. There are various studies about menstrual hygiene in India. One of them claims that nearly 50% of women still claims menstruation as dirty, and they use dirty clothes all their life. And it is not surprising that they are prone to some dangerous diseases, including cervical cancer. There is another study which indicates that only 30% of Indian women are able to access sanitary products. An estimated 70% of reproductive diseases in Indian women are caused by poor menstrual hygiene, and yet people are not comfortable talking about it. And this applies to even educated households. And more ironically, the sanitary product brand that is leading in India also reflects this cultural taboo. Things have improved a little in the last decade or so. Women's rights organizations have stood up against luxury taxes on these sanitary products. Commercial and documentary films have brought awareness among the masses. No doubt awareness is more important, but affordability and availability is also important, which has often been ignored. Now, if you see a pack of sanitary products cost somewhere around 100 to 250 rupees, most low-income families cannot afford this. There are a few non-profit organizations which are manufacturing sanitary products for a very low cost, say for 10 rupees or so, and distributing it to the low-income people. But they are not able to cater to all. They cater to only some specific categories of people. The high price of sanitary products has always been a concern with women in India. And with the latest pandemic that has come, whatever little avenue they had to get free products has also been blocked. With all those schools having been closed for the last 8 months or so, those school girls cannot also afford the facility of having free sanitary products. According to a report by BBC, only 35% of the 355 million menstruating women in India are able to access sanitary products. This is really a huge gap. When the lockdown was imposed on the nation to suppress the coronavirus pandemic, there was a little movement of goods, and government has exempted movement of essential commodity items. But there was a confusion with regards to the sanitary products. What happened is, when the availability of sanitary napkins became perilous, the government has to intervene and clarify its position that sanitary products is in fact considered as an essential commodity. What is important to note is that in cases like this, in case of natural calamity or for that matter man-made calamity, it is important that we should go ahead and distribute sanitary napkins wherever needed to the poorest of people who are living in the slums. Some of the NGOs and social workers have been manufacturing and distributing the same wherever it is needed, but there are tremendous problems associated with women in the tribal villages due to its non-availability. It is not only the NGOs and social workers, but the responsibility of the government to provide free sanitary products to people who need them. And also, when there is a scarcity, there are chances that young girls may reuse it for a longer period than it is advisable. It is the duty of the government to see that women and girls get the right to menstrual hygiene. Menstruation is normal. But not talking about it when required affects how girls and women take the information, assess the hygiene products and look for necessary healthcare. Breaking the deeply embedded culture of silence can go a long way in improving the health and well-being of girls and women in the country. On 15th of August 2020, the Prime Minister of India, in his Independence Day address, openly spoke about menstruation and sanitary pads in a country where millions don't talk about this openly, which in fact is a positive step. Scotland's decision to make all period products free brings hope to a country like India, which may probably follow this example. As Scottish politician Monica Lennon said, "These are not luxury items. These are essential items, and nobody should have to go without period products." India should definitely take steps in this direction, and all efforts should be made that sanitary products should be made available to all, and a law should come into force soon, which will be in the favor of women. What is more important is the health of girls and women, and this should be in the political agenda of all political parties. Every year, a sizable amount of budget should be set aside, which should be allocated for free sanitary products, and this should be made available to people who are in need, who are not able to buy, or at a very low price, a subsidized product, which I'm sure everybody will be in its favor. Being able to access sanitary products is fundamental to human rights, equality, and dignity. Not only India, all the countries in the world should come together and think about this issue seriously and make it as a universal law. It will go a long way in improving the health and well-being of girls and women. Thank you. See you soon and take care.